Hey guys, so in the last neuroimaging related video I did, I talked about how to anonymize an MRI scan, and as part of that, I talked about how to deface an MRI. So in that video, I talked about how to deface using FreeSurfer, and I mentioned that it does it automatically basically, and sometimes the result is not correct. So I said that there's probably a lot of other ways to deface an MRI, and so in this video, I'm going to go over another way using another program. So there is this program called FieldTrip. It's free. I'll put it all these little links in the description box. But it's basically a program that is like a folder full of functions that you can add to MATLAB. So if you download that, it's mostly for EEG and MEG data, but it does have some functions for MRI data as well. So it has an option to deface MRIs, and it's a little bit different from how the FreeSurfer defaces MRIs. So I'm going to go over how it works in this video. So I'm going to skip the part where you download FieldTrip and add it to your directory in MATLAB. So I already did that. If you have to do that, it's like any other MATLAB function or program in that you have to set the path and add the FieldTrip folder to your path in MATLAB. And then after you have that done, then you can get started using it. So it's a really simple process to deface. You want to get whatever MRI scan you have. So for me, it's going to be in users, and then I have it in my download folder. So it's going to be this Nifty, and it doesn't have to be a Nifty. It can be, I think it'll recognize most file extensions, but for me, I'm just going to use Nifty, and it has a couple lines of code here that you can use. So the first code is to put in what the MRI data is called. So you do that, and then you create this empty array, and then you put in this line of code. So that's going to open a figure box, and the figure box is going to let you manually create your defaced MRI. That opens up. So I like using the FieldTrip method of deface because you can do everything manually. So this yellow box is what's going to be removed from the image, and it's showing you a three-dimensional view of what the image looks like. So you click this little button, and then you can rotate to see from any angle that you want. And you're going to change or move the box using these little buttons down here. So you can rotate the box on any of its three axes. You can scale it to be larger or smaller, and you move it using translate. So I'm going to try to move it obviously to this lower right-hand corner. So I'm going to just play around with the numbers, and you can do negative as well. So negative will move it down. I think I want it more to the right. And you want to try to get some of the eyes if possible. Okay, so I think I'm fine with the values that I have here. It's going to remove the box shown in yellow. So when you're done with that, you just exit out of the figure, and it saves the voxel changes that you want. And then you can check what it's going to remove using these two lines. So if you copy that, it's going to open up and show you what's going to be removed. So if you traverse through a couple slices, I could have moved it back a little bit, but it does remove, I think, enough of the eye and enough of the mouth to be, well, I could have removed more of the eye, but it's mostly defaced. So as an example, that's fine. And then the last line is this, where it writes it to a new Nifty file. And the only thing you have to change is whatever you want to call the new file. So I can change it to MAD underscore deface dot Nifty. Click enter, and that will write it into your folder. So you now have a defaced Nifty. And then you can look at your Nifty again that's been defaced. So when I do that, you can actually see my box was not really that great because I I missed the whole eyeball. I probably could have done a better job of it, but you get the idea, and it's a really good option to manually deface, so you are already making sure that you're not going to have any errors because you're doing it manually and you can check what's being removed, and you can make sure you're not removing any parts of the brain. Alright, so that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.